Thank you. now have a 10-minute intermission, and then we'll finish off with the Mozart.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Staff Sergeant Nick Hodges. I'm violist in the Army Strings, and we're really happy to be here tonight playing for you. So just to take kind of an informal poll, who enjoyed the last piece, the Penderecki? Good, this is great. Yeah. It's always, when you program a concert, you think about what does the audience want to hear, what do we want to play, and you find that intersection. Some pieces the audience doesn't know, some pieces we don't know, so it's fun to put them on in between things that people know. So Penderecki was born in 1933 in Poland. So if you think what's going on there, the country has been devastated by World War I and about to be devastated by World War II. And of course, as a little boy, he's learning about the atrocities of the Holocaust and nuclear bombs going off in Japan to try to end the war. So it's not really a surprise in 1950-something when he started composing that his music was aggressive, noisy, and something that we hadn't heard before. He used extended techniques like scratch tones. He told the performers to play behind the bridge. This isn't a joke, this is real. He said, pizzicato up and down the instrument as fast as you can. And then in 1970-something, he decided to stop doing that. However, if you look at movies and you cover the TV and you just listen when there's a chase scene or a horror movie or something, you'll hear all of those things. So he actually had a big lasting impact, even though he was kind of making noise. The piece you heard, though, was not that style. And by the way, his most famous of that type of composing is called Threnody for the Victims of Hiroshima. So I encourage you to look it up. It's a great piece, and it's pretty horrifying and scary sounding. The piece we just played is not in that style. It was composed in 1993, and at the premiere, the audience enjoyed it so much they clapped and clapped that they played it a second time. And incidentally, they used a conductor. We didn't. And I learned about the conductor after we had already performed it once. So, anyway, if you like Penderecki's music, I encourage you to find it, look it up, see what else he has to offer. And now we're about to play something completely different.
So this last quartet that we're about to play for you is personally one of my favorite pieces in the clarinet chamber repertoire. Which is strange coming from a clarinet player, because this actually is not entirely authentic. It's actually a piano trio, originally for a piano and strings. What happened was, in the decade after Mozart's death, there were there was this great surge in interest in what he had been doing, and so there was a lot of arranging going on, and it's not clear whose name should go on this piece. While the piece is Mozart's, the arranger is unknown. It's assumed to be, I think it's Johann André, who was working closely with his wife to get all of these works published posthumously. And incidentally, this piece is on a recording by a clarinet player that I absolutely adore. And I used the first page to warm up. Even before I had seen the music, I loved it so much that I had learned to play it by ear. And his sound is in my head my ideal clarinet sound, which is what I strive to play like every time I pick up my instrument. So hopefully you enjoy this quartet as much as I do. Thank you for coming.
Thank you. swab and string players tune in the middle of a piece, I feel like they should send out rodeo clowns. Don't look over here, folks.
Yeah, I almost made a joke about strings tuning, and then I thought, no, I'm not going to do that. We all have our quirks, and here I am swabbing.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming. As you know, it's not a performance without an audience. It's just a practice session, so we really appreciate that you came out to hear us tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.